school on here. This is your favorite economics class. All this while we've been talking about international economic organizations. We're able to look at so many examples of international organizations, the ones governing the world and the ones related to Africa. Then we consider the IMF, National Monetary Fund, able to look at World Bank, consider OPEC, that is Organization Petroleum of Exporting Countries. We're able to consider the United Nations on Trade, United Nations Conference on Trade and Development. Also, down to Africa, we have considered the Economic Commission for Africa, ECA. We also look at ECOWAS, that is Economic Community of West African States. Today, we want to continue on international economic organizations examples related to Africa. Today, we want to look at African Development Bank, ADB, African Development Bank. So, the historical background, it was established in 1964 with headquarters in Abidjan, Cote d'Ivoire. It's just a bank owned by African countries, which belong to the African Union. Jointly set up by the effort of AU, that is African Union, and the ECA, that is Economic Commission for Africa. It started full operation in 1966 with initial membership of 23 African countries. And as at 1970, membership has risen to 31. So, I want to look at the objective of African Development Bank. What are the objectives? What are the aims? Provision of loans to aid social and economic development of member nations. So, we can see as part of the objectives of African Development Bank is to provide loans. Loans. And these loans will be used to develop the for economic development among the member states. And the member states include the countries in Africa. And as we have seen from the historical background or historical development, that we have about 31 countries in Africa that are members of African Development Bank. Provision of technical assistance for development projects and programs embarked upon by member nations. So we can see from the objectives, there's a provision of technical assistance. In case any nation need technical assistance, there will be provision by African Development Bank to such a member state. Then also develop technical assistance to in terms of the development projects and programs. And these are the things that are crucial to economic development in various countries of Africa. Provision of funds for agricultural development of member nations. As we can see, the major area of production in Africa, or sector, or industry, is agriculture. So most countries in Africa embark on agricultural activities, and there should be funds made available. So each member state has the capacity, or has the free will, or has the ability to approach African Development Bank in order to collect loans to boost agricultural production. Here, I want to look at the roles. What are the role of African development banks? What are their contributions? One, it fosters economic integration among the member states. You can see it, the member states, as we are able to see, the 31 member states, there's what called an economic integration. The members have a common interest. They have common economic interests and goals to achieve. And the overall achievement will be economic development. So we can see from there that it fosters economic integration among the member states. There is also provision of funds for the supply and development of infrastructural facilities. Infrastructural facilities such as water, electricity. Also, we look at telecommunication. So this area, we can see that if there will be development in infrastructure, Africa Development Banks encourages this. It fosters, it facilitates it among the member states so that the infrastructural development will speed up. Promotion of both private and public investment in projects which contribute to the economic and social development of member states. Here we can see whether it is private or public investment. Investment in what area? In projects. And also there will be contribution into the economic and social development of the member states. So we can see that as part of the contribution of African Development Bank to African nations, to want to facilitate social and economic development, and also encouraging private and public investments. Investment in projects, whether it is capital projects or any other projects it might come up. Now I want to consider another international economic organization, and this time looking at West African Clearing House. West Africa Clearing House, WACH. Now I want to look at the historical development. It was established in June 1975 with its headquarters in Freetown. And Freetown is the capital of Sierra Leone. It has English and French as the official working language. So we can see the uniqueness of this organization, because the member states are the Francophones and the Anglophone, that is the French-speaking countries and the English-speaking countries. So automatically, the working language should be both French and English. Now, it is a multilateral clearinghouse which comprises 15 member central bank of West African states of. So we can see that we have 15 member states, and those member states consist of the central banks of different countries. So the central banks have alliance or link with West Africa Clearing House. It is a multilateral clearinghouse which comprises 15 member central banks of West Africa. States of Nigeria, looking at some of the states, although some of the member states included, and some of these states, we have Nigeria as a country there, Republic of Benin, Côte d'Ivoire, Niger, Senegal, Togo, Burkina Faso, Gambia, Ghana, Guinea, Guinea-Bissau, Liberia, Mali, Mauritania, and finally Sierra Leone. So we could see that all these countries are members of Africa Development Banks, and what they do is to promote the financial, social, and economic development in the various countries. Want to consider the objectives of West African Clearinghouse. One of the objectives is to promote the use of members' national currencies for intra-subregional transactions. Promoting the use of members' national currencies for intra, that is within the subregion. Whatever the transactions that will be coming up within the subregion, just to promote. When we talk about different currencies, like the currencies in Africa, we have different types. Nigeria has its own, which is Naira and Kobo. Then we have that of other countries that make use of CFAs. We have some countries that make use of CDs. We have some RAN, and so on, different currencies. So we could see from here that many of our country, the members of WACH, that is the West Africa Clearinghouse, making use of the promoting, that is that's part of the objectives, to promote the use of these national currencies, so that the currencies will be a popular one, like the ones of the developed nations. So within the subregion, it should be used. Another point under the objective is to bring robust savings in the use of foreign reserves. So just to encourage savings so that the foreign reserve will be in order, promoting and encouraging the members to be able to save and to use the foreign reserves. I want to talk about the roles of West African Clearinghouse. Here, promoting monetary cooperation in the sub-region. Promoting monetary cooperation in the sub-region. So within the member states, within the sub-region, in terms of the monetary cooperation, it has to be promoted. Monetary cooperation, what are we talking about? That is the various ways transactions are taking place and money is in circulation. So these, there should be cooperation among them within their own country and also within the sub-region. Encouraging trade liberalization. So we can see that trade liberalization has to be encouraged. And what we mean by trade liberalization is free trade. No barrier. All this protectionism, the barriers has to be removed so that there will be free access into various markets within the sub-region. The member states have the free will just to sell their goods and services, to present them and even to sell them within the sub-region without any form of restriction. So we able to see that African Development Bank has a great potential to develop Africa in terms of finance, the economic and social activities of the entire member states. So there we're able to see again the members of African Development Bank, see how they are able to come together even with having a common interest to boost economic development within the region. As part of the roles and objectives, the objectives and the role of African Development Bank, we're able to see loans given out to different African countries in order to boost different sectors of the economy, the primary, the secondary, and the tertiary sector. But mostly in the area of the primary sector, an example is agricultural production, so that at least they will be able to move on. In the secondary sector of the economy, the manufacturing, ADB, that is African Development Bank, also as part of their contribution is to fast track industrialization, that is making funds available for industries to be established in the sub-region, that is among the member states. And we're able to see various activities of African Development Bank. Later, we now move down to West Africa, West African Clearing House. West African Clearing House could see the numbers of members of West African Clearing House and the various activities. So there, we're able to look at the roles and objective of West African Clearing House. So we could see the member countries, both of the French-speaking countries and that of the English-speaking countries, that is the Francophone and the Anglophones. Examples of the countries, the member states include Nigeria, Republic of Benin, Cote d'Ivoire, Niger, Senegal, Togo, Burkina Faso, Gambia, Ghana, Guinea-Bissau, Liberia, Mali, Mauritania, and that of Sierra Leone. So we can see all the member states, just about 15 member states, having the same and common objectives and goals. So at the end of our study, we want to assess ourselves and see how far do we understand the contributions, various contributions, the objectives and the roles of these organizations. The first question says, mention some of the functions of African Development Banks. And two, highlight the objectives of West African Clearing House. The answer should be forwarded to the address as you see on the screen. Happy viewing